The U.S. authorization of two COVID-19 vaccines marked a turning point in the pandemic and vaccine science. These vaccines use messenger RNA, or mRNA, to deliver immunity. mRNA are short strands of instructions used to build proteins. It's impossible for these mRNA vaccines to alter our DNA in any way. Although that technology has been in development for decades, mRNA vaccines hadn't made it to market until now. There are a few ways to make a vaccine. Most use a version of the pathogen they are trying to protect you against, like the flu or measles, to trigger an immune response. You can think of vaccines like a biological wanted poster. They show our bodies how to recognize the enemy, an antigen, such as a harmful virus or bacteria, so we know how to react if it ever shows up. Our bodies will be prepared to send T cells to attack infected cells, and B cells to produce antibodies, which neutralize the virus and prevent it from invading healthy cells. mRNA vaccines use innovative technology to deliver protection. If traditional vaccines deliver wanted posters, these vaccines carry USB drives with instructions that tell our cellular machinery how to print its own poster. In other words, they instruct the body to make its own antigens. In the case of the coronavirus, the antigen is the infamous spike protein that attaches to and infects your cells. These vaccines use mRNA, a molecule that our cells need to create any type of protein to introduce us to that spike. To start, researchers isolated the part of the coronavirus's genetic sequence that codes for the spike protein. Then, they put an mRNA molecule containing the code into a super tiny drug delivery system known as a lipid nanoparticle, which can enter our cells. Inside the cell, ribosomes use the code to create a protein chain that resembles the enemy, the coronavirus's spike protein. Those cells can then temporarily display a lookalike of that protein, which prompts our immune cells to respond as if it were an antigen from a traditional vaccine.